What if a city could tell its story? Would it help us understand and make better decisions about our urban surroundings? As a designer, I have now worked with urban planning and challenges of participatory processes for more or less a decade, and I'd like to share with you some of the things that I have learned on how we can use immersive technologies to better understand the urban environment. To begin with, a city does not have one story, to be exact. Cities are complex. They are driven by a myriad of different interests, opinions, and desires. Urban areas are home for the majority of the people in the world today, and at the same time, they are ecologically important. Cities are largely affected by, but also shape the changes in climate and biodiversity, which are two key components of the Earth system. Although cities cover just 3% of Earth's surface, they account for 75% of all carbon emissions. How we plan cities is crucial for the future of humanity, but also our planet. As it is now, the discussion and debate on the future of the cities is very technology-driven. We talk of smart cities, but out of thousands of academic papers published on the subject, only very few focus on social sustainability. Yet, the merit of technologies depends on how they are used. For them to work as tools for making cities more livable now and in the future, we need to ask how people can be more involved in urban planning, design, and long-term management. Data-driven decision-making has many merits, but we need to ask if the data used for facilitating decisions is fairly and equally collected, interpreted, and presented. We need diverse sets of perspectives and knowledge to face the often complex urban challenges, to make cities that are sustainable and can adapt to sudden, unexpected changes, even crises. We need collaboration across and beyond professional borders. In addition to architects, landscape architects, and traffic planners, we need different social, environmental, and financial experts, as well as us, the people who live in the cities. But this is something that is more easily said than done. You see, planning urban environments is a long-term process and a complex one in its own. The future under debate does not exist yet. We merely have plans, visualizations, and simulations of an estimated future. And often enough, this can be difficult to read for those of us who are not urban planners by trade. And important aspects might go unnoticed because of this. And this poses a challenge for collaboration, collaborative design, and public participation. As we extend the scope of participation to include a more diverse group of people, we need to better communication tools so that everyone involved understands the topics and proposals in a similar way. So how then can immersive technologies extend our understanding of the urban environment? Human beings are primarily visual species. Our brains have evolved over millions of years to live in and analyze information in a multidimensional world. We are also very good at spotting patterns and differences in them. And actually, the whole discipline of information visualization builds on this. Visualizations draw and focus attention to meaningful connections and help draw insights out of data. And now, with new technologies, also new opportunities open up. Immersive technologies, or XR, extended reality that is an umbrella term for technologies that create, augment, and merge digital elements with physical space. It includes both VR, or virtual reality, where we are fully immersed in the created space, and augmented reality, or AR, where you still see the existing reality around you, but also computer-generated elements that are layered on top of that. The project that I have now led for the past 3 years, Augmented Urbans, has explored the ways for XR technologies to support urban planning that invites and makes use of different knowledge. And this is us, the we that I speak of. Our team of urban planners, architects, researchers, designers, students, technology developers, and active citizens from 4 countries and 7 cities and municipalities around the Baltic Sea. We started not from the technology, but from local context, by understanding the needs within 5 ongoing planning processes that we have used as case studies. We have asked questions like, can we use these technologies to help reach new people and bring them around the planning table? And is there a way that we could visualize complex information like ecosystem services? And could we, by doing that, bring those more in consideration when planning urban space? Based on this 3 years of experience, the technology shows a lot of promise. When we started, there were not that many applications or trials out there, but the number is growing. While extended reality represents only a small segment of the digitalization of urban planning processes, what makes it special and interesting is the potential connection point to us humans, an interface to present urban data and facilitate participation. What the extended reality allows us is, for one, the virtual visit and experience urban spaces, be they already existing or still future visions, and then to discuss and co-ideate on their future development and prospects together. XR also broadens the understanding of urban space, being able to view, for example, historical layers within a neighborhood illustrates that the urban environment is not fixed, but ever shifting with the decisions that we make today. And realizing this can be actually quite empowering. As compared to regular architectural visualizations, VR immerses the viewer into the planned space and offers a more vivid perception how it will look and feel when implemented. A virtual experience that we developed for receiving public inputs for on a street plan in Helsinki, the capital of Finland, by the way, allows walking or teleporting freely around the square under development and comparing the proposed plan to existing space in different seasons, weathers, and times of day. And you can also jump in the future and see how the trees will grow and see some information about the ecosystem services that they provide. Extended reality is essentially an experience, and as such, can be powerful. Compared to reading through scientific materials, seeing urban areas and their changes in VR or AR are deep and rich experiences. And this power comes with a great responsibility. In Stockholm, capital of Sweden, VR prototype sets out to show how nature benefits the city. By visualizing largely invisible ecosystem services provided by urban greenery, we, for instance, get to see how plants increase in housing and inhabitants, and estimated increase in private cars might affect the air quality. We then see how choices that we make with landscape design can help counterbalance the potential negative of these changes. With XR, we can draw attention to things that often go unnoticed in everyday urban life. For example, pollinating insects, bumblebees, bees, butterflies that are critically important to our ecosystem. The city of Tallinn, capital of Estonia, did just this. With an AR application activated by pointing a mobile phone to a mural on site, the urban planners share information about the existing green space, which is currently a high-voltage power cable corridor waiting to become a more inviting and multifunctional park and route for cyclists and pedestrians. Via the phone screen, we see 3D animations nestled within the existing urban space that share a story of different species that already live there, insects and plants. Although at its current state and on a quick glance, it might seem that the site is neglected. And about the plants that are envisioned to keep the site livable for those species, but also make it more attractive place for people to spend time in. With this, citizens get to experience a glimpse of the future there on site in real existing reality, well before the long-term city plans turn into a reality. While AR can draw attention to those aspects that are invisible or hard to notice in existing space, VR immerses the user in the perspectives that are presented, and its capacity to elicit empathy is a growing research field. With VR, we can essentially step in the shoes of someone else to see what they see and hear their story. This can be something as simple as viewing the city from a different height than you normally do, and getting a feel how the elements in urban space feel from that perspective, or listening to other people's experiences of the space as you stand immersed in it. In Helsinki, we touched upon this when using 360-degree videos filmed on the planning site to visualize the existing urban space. The videos included voiceover narrations with citizen comments about the space that were previously collected via online questionnaires. And these illustrated quite nicely the variety of personal spatial experiences and how planning needs to balance those different perspectives. But broadening the perspective can also take us even beyond human species. In the UK, for example, there is this really cool VR experience that lets you see forest through the eyes of a frog, an owl, or a dragonfly. The opportunities that come with extended realities are knit tightly into the broader spectrum of digitalizing urban planning processes. Many cities are now producing so-called digital twins, which are virtual copies of urban environment and system. By including huge amounts of information, these aim at better understanding cities, their past events, the current status, and what action should be taken for future, and all this for better governance. The question is, how do we use such models and their rich data to strengthen the democratic decision-making? XR enters the picture as one potential interface for accessing and reviewing data, but also as a tool that we can use for designing urban future together in co-creation processes based on utilizing availability of that increasingly rich data. At its best, XR can offer us the means to extend our perception, see through the eyes of another, and understand the plurality of different perspectives. It can provide us with an interface to explore and analyze information collected from our urban surroundings. It can draw our attention and visualize largely invisible flows to help us understand better the complex system which is around us, that is the city. With the ongoing climate and biodiversity crisis, cities are facing increasingly complex challenges that call for broad collaboration. While not a silver bullet, XR technology can offer us the means to make future scenarios more understandable for a wider group of people and help collecting their ideas on the pathways in the future. Just as virtual spaces, our urban futures do not yet exist, but they are being created. What XR can do is help us to work together on our quest for more livable future cities. We all play a part in shaping the next chapters of the story, and I would argue that the better we can envision it, the easier it is for us to make those good ones. Thank you.